When you have a pet who's in end stages, you and I spoke before about there being, you know, the time where it's too early and the time where it's too late,
right.
And then anywhere right in between is an appropriate time for euthanizing. That being said, how does an owner, a dog guardian, assess their pet's quality of life to be able to help them make that decision even more tightly?
Rating your dog's pain from 0 to 5, or sleeping, either sleeping way more than usual or way less than usual. I think about whether or not the pet can do their favorite things. So if you tell me your dog lives for the ball and barking at the mailman and rolling over on his back, and now all he can do is sit there and have his ears rubbed, he's not doing the things that bring him joy. And I think that that's really important. So I've come up with 14 different categories that owners can go through with the veterinarian to help them really assess how their pet is doing. But I think you have to just think about whether or not this dog is happy, and would you want to trade places with your dog? Or do you look at him and feel sad and have pity on him because of the way his life has turned? And so when you have pity and you feel sorry for them, and another thing that happens is I often hear people say they just wish they would die on their own. I hear it often. You know, when you walk down the stairs and you sort of peek and see if they're still alive, and secretly you're hoping that they would just pass in the night, I think people know that it's time. So that helps them assess.
What are the differences between dogs and cats, the end stages process?
There are many similarities, but there are some differences. The major differences are when we look at the lifestyle that the pet has or the cat has. So for example, with dogs, one of the things people can look at is if they're still wanting to go out for walks, if they're still really interactive with people, if they greet people at the door. We know cats don't do that. Cats march to their own beat. And so it is quite normal for a healthy cat to be sleeping on the couch when you go to work during the day, and you come home and they are still sleeping on the couch. If that was a dog, you might think a little differently because they are a little bit more active during the day, but cats, not so much. So I don't necessarily look at the amount of exercise that a cat does during the day to help me assess their quality of life. And some of the things that we'll look at for cats would be if they're still using their litter box or choosing other places to go. For example, if the litter box is in the basement, the cat may choose not to go all the way down into the basement if they are having mobility problems or arthritis because it's too hard for them to go up and down the stairs. Some cats, you will notice, normally will jump onto the couch, and now they're not jumping. They just sort of stand there and look at the couch and want to go, but they can't. And so mobility tends to be a big thing that people notice with cats, mm-hmm. Or their behavior. Mm-hmm. Maybe you sit and snuggle with your cat in the evenings, and now they no longer want to do that. They're just hiding somewhere else. So a lot of the things that we look out for in dogs and cats would be changes in behavior.